We want to simplify the given square roots, but let's start with a quick review. If a squared is equal to b, then a is the square root of b. So for example, since 4 squared is equal to 16, then the square root of 16 is equal to 4. But it's also true that negative 4 squared is equal to 16. So negative 4 is also a square root of 16. But using the notation we have here, these are called principal square roots, and we're only concerned about the positive square roots. So for the square root of 9, we want to know what number squared, or what number times itself, is equal to 9. Well, to show some work here, we can write 9 as 3 times 3. Therefore, the square root of 9 is equal to 3. This means that 3 squared is equal to 9, so 3 is the principal square root of 9. So whenever we have two equal factors underneath the square root, it's always going to simplify to just one of those factors. We have two factors of 3 here, so it simplifies to one factor of 3. For the square root of 36, we want to know what number times itself is equal to 36, or what number squared is equal to 36. And again, since we can write 36 as 6 times 6, which is 6 squared, the square root of 36 is equal to 6. Again, the reason for this is that 6 squared is equal to 36. And remember, we're only talking about the positive square roots here because of the notation. Again, notice how we have two equal factors here, so it simplifies to one of those factors. Now looking at this third example, this one's not quite as easy because the number underneath the square root is rather large, and this is called the radicand. So if we can't determine the square root by inspection, we can use the prime factorization of the number to help us simplify the square root. So we'll determine the prime factorization of 196. Well, it's even, so that would be 2 times 98, and 2 is prime. 98 is even, that would be 2 times 49, and 2 is prime. And 49 is equal to 7 times 7, which are both prime. So that tells us that 196 is equal to 2 times 2 times 7 times 7. Well, again, remember, whenever we have two equal factors, we have a perfect square. So here's a perfect square, and here's a perfect square. And the square root of 2 times 2 would just be one factor of 2, and the square root of 7 times 7 would be one factor of 7. And so the square root of 196 is equal to this product, which is 14. So 14 is the square root of 196 because 14 squared is equal to 196. Okay, I hope you found these examples helpful.